everyone. I'm Mandy, and I'm the Programs and Events Assistant here at the Scott Arboretum, sharing our hashtag BranchOut Digital Learning Series, where we share new programming every Wednesday for every gardening enthusiast. So I'm here today to share a mini nature-based lesson and art activity that's perfect for kids and for families to share together. Have you ever done a leaf rubbing? Well, it's a very popular nature activity where you gather a whole bunch of different kinds of leaves that are different shapes and sizes, and then you put them down on a surface, you put paper on top, take a crayon and rub, 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 and you get a really beautiful impression from that leaf that's colorful and interesting, and you have a great picture. So we're going to take that activity today, we're going to crank it up a notch, and we're going to use all different kinds of natural materials. And we're also going to use different colors as well to create a bit of a collage effect. So if you've ever done an art collage, you take lots of different kinds of materials and you glue them down on a surface and you create this whole new picture. And that's the idea today with our natural materials. So I'm going to bring in my daughter Sophie to help me out with this art activity. So come on over, Sophie. Thank you so much for joining us. She's such a great artist, so I'm very lucky to have her help me out today. So, like many of our other projects that we've done here at the Scott Arboretum, the artistic process for this starts the same way as many of our other activities, to go outside, explore nature, and start collecting some materials.
Yeah.
So you can see we have a smattering of things on the table here. Some tips: look for natural materials that have definitive edges and textures, and also that can be flattened out. If they're too puffy, they might rip the paper and it just doesn't work very well. Things can be a little bit dried out, but not so dried out that they are brittle and they might break when you rub a crayon on top of it.
Yeah.
So here are some of the things we collected. We have some bark. So Sophie, would you show us our little piece of bark that we have here? Now it's a kind of a small flat piece, but we found it gave some very cool interest when we used it. And we have, let's see, what else do we have? We have lots of different kinds of leaves. So we have some smaller leaves, we have some bigger leaves. Do you want to hold up an example of two different kinds of leaves we have here? Yep. And then we have some branches with needles on them. Yeah. We even have a little bit of moss. We didn't have a ton, we had a little bit in our patio, so you can pull out some moss. It makes for some very cool texture. And we have a little bit of some of this weedy guy. And it has some tiny little flowers, and that looked pretty cool. So some weeds might work that you have that might have some interesting little shapes and leaves on there. We even have some of these long, skinny leaves. So leaves of all different shapes, sizes, and textures. These are from actually a daylily plant. Categories that we put trees into: deciduous and evergreen. So deciduous trees are trees that lose their leaves every year. So typically they drop their leaves around fall, and then they get new buds in the spring. And so examples of that would be like your oak trees, your maple trees. We also have evergreens, and that's a plant where its leaves or needles stay green throughout the year. And so most species of conifers, which are typical trees that usually they have needles and they have pine cones. And so examples of that might be like, I said, pine trees, hemlock trees, blue spruces, and also hollies, holly trees. And we do have some holly leaves as well because they really have a nice stiff structure to them. So we picked up a couple leaves before. I'm going to test Sophie a little bit. So what do you think about this red maple?
Deciduous.
Yes, absolutely. That comes from a deciduous tree. Very good. And how about this guy right over here? It comes from a blue spruce, like your typical Christmas tree. So maybe when you go out and collect materials for your nature rubbing, you can see when you look for different kinds of leaves and needles, if you can figure out if they come from a deciduous or an evergreen tree. It's kind of a fun little activity. So once you have gathered all your materials, the next step is to, if you're going to do it inside, spread them out. Maybe you want to have a little mat to collect any dirt that you bring from your outside materials. We always have our little orange mat down. Spread out, see what you like. We actually got so much extra stuff, we ended up having to get rid of some of it. So you might want to sort through, see what works really well. We actually initially used some flowers and we found they were a little too flimsy and they didn't transfer well. So you might want to do a few practice sessions with a few of your materials and see what works really well. You, another tip is you want to turn your leaves upside down. So they have these really great, this has this great veining on the underneath of this maple leaf, and we want to be able to see that when we rub the crayon over it. So Sophie, why don't you go ahead and get started and see if you can grab the materials you're interested in and start to create maybe a bit of a pattern. You want to make sure it's about the same size as your paper. So let's talk about paper. So besides your natural materials, you need a nice piece of paper. I would recommend just a plain white sheet. I would not recommend construction paper that is too thick or tracing paper that's too thin. It might rip. So we actually found that just regular old computer paper. So actually, here's some examples of some of the ones Sophie and I did earlier. I'm going to just hold these up for a second. And we just used plain old computer paper, and it worked great. So if you have that around, that'll work. For our example today, we're going to use a slightly bigger piece of art paper that we just got from an art pad. Just so you can see a little better, we're going to use that bigger piece of paper. So that's what works the best. You also want to make sure you have crayons. So thank you, Sophie. You want to have crayons where you rip the paper off, because we're actually going to do the rubbing on the side of the crayon. That creates the most surface space and gives the nicest look of color. So we just have like 5 or 6 different colors. So you don't need to unwrap all your crayons. Just choose a few of the favorite colors you want to use. So it looks like Sophie's created a bit of a pattern. And then once you have them spread out, so you don't want to overlap them. We tried to do that. We found we really couldn't see the shape and the texture well enough. So I'm just going to spread yours out just a tad, Sophie. So it looks like she used some maple leaves, some holly leaves, some pachysandra, some blue spruce needles, bark, and a little bit of that funky little weed we found.
Yeah.
You take your paper, you place it on top of your natural materials, and then you just work slowly from one piece to the next. And don't be afraid to lift up your piece of paper back and forth. Once you start the leaf rubbing, you want to really hold the paper down tight so your material doesn't move. And you want to rub fairly hard so you get all those little details, those textures. Oh, that looks really great. So you're using different colors here. Yeah, Sophie's just checking to make sure she got the full length of the branch. A little bit of moss.
Yeah.
Very nice. You can use even 2 different colors if you like. So you could do one color, and then you could experiment by putting another color on top. Mm-hmm. It's really fun to just rub, and see what it looks like when it comes through on the other side. It transfers magic. It's almost like magic. And she's using that nice long daylily. Excellent. So you want to hold that up, Sophie, so they can start to see. So probably we'd normally put out a little more materials and spend a little time. We're just giving you a little brief example. That looks really great and colorful. Mm-hmm. Awesome. So I hope you had fun creating and learning about nature rubbings today. Thank you so much, Sophie. Thank you so much for joining us today. And hopefully you learned a little bit about deciduous versus evergreen trees. And
sure
you'll
go
out and test your knowledge when you're collecting things. If you do make one, please snap a picture and send it to me at, upside down, mbanks1@swarthmore.edu. There we go. That is my email address. And I would love to see what you do. Maybe they'll show up on our Creative Corner link under the Scott Arboretum at Home link on our webpage. So I hope you keep checking us out on Wednesdays when we share new branch out digital learning offerings. We'll have a new nature-based lesson and art activity coming up soon. I hope you check us back then. Until then, I wish you and your family health and happiness and encourage you to get out into nature and explore. Bye-bye.
Bye.